Hi everyone, in this video we will go through few 5 marker problems related to theory of indices. Here we will have to figure out the unknowns such as value of x, value of k. Now here are a set of problems where we have to solve. Solve meaning we will have to find the values of unknowns or variables. What are unknowns or variables here? X. So these x values we will have to find. That is what is meant by solve. When you have such problems where you have to the power x, right? If you have 3 to the power x, 4 to the power x, right? Anything, if you have a power as x, y or z, right? Any unknown as a power, any variable as the power, you put this as k, right? So you can say 3 to the power x as k. If I put 3 to the power x as k, why I'm putting 3 to the power x? Because there is 2 times you're getting 3 to the power x here and there is also here 3 to the power x. So I'll substitute k here. So remember, this is 3 to the power 2x. I can write this as 3 to the power x. I can write it like this because I can multiply the powers. When I multiply the powers, it's going to become 2x, right? So I can split this. I can split this like this. And I can write 3 to the power x as k. And then I have this 2 here. So it will be k square. So k square minus 10 into k plus 9. This is called as a quadratic equation. There are two methods to solve these equations. One is sum product. Second one is formula. If you have to find the value of this unknown, right, these unknown values, x or k or whatever, then there are two ways to do it, sum product and formula, right? Now, formula method is, you have to write x is equal to minus b plus or minus root of b square minus 4ac by 2a. If you use this formula, this is for the equation ax square plus bx plus c is equal to 0. When you have equation of this form, like this, k square minus 10k plus 9, ax square plus bx plus c, you will have to use this formula to find the roots. This is one method. The other method is sum product, right? You can refer my video in the playlist for these two particular methods, how to use these methods to solve such equations. For now, I'll use sum product method. We have it like this. This is the equation. So, sum would be this one, minus 10, and product would be 9. This one. Now I have to choose two numbers whose product is 9 and whose sum is 10. Two numbers, number 1 and number 2. If I choose 9 and 1, when I multiply 9 and 1, I'll get 9. And when I add 9 and 1, I'll get 10. Right? But I have to also consider signs. So it should be minus 10 and plus 9. So I can make these numbers as minus 9, minus 1. Minus 9 into minus 1 is plus 9. Minus 9 plus minus 1 is minus 10. So this is sum product method. So the numbers are k minus 9 and k minus 1. Minus 9 and minus 1 are the numbers. So k minus 9 and k minus 1. So this is the factors basically. Now I write this entire equation as k minus 9 and k minus 1. You can try this out. When you multiply k minus 9 with k minus 1, you will get this equation. So this is reverse way of getting the factors for an equation. Now if k minus 9 is equal to 0, k minus 9 is equal to 0 means k is equal to 9. Now k minus 1 is equal to 0 means k is equal to, shift this here, 1. So that's what we have got. K is equal to 9, k is equal to 1. Now let's remember this. We had assumed that k is 3 to the power x. K is 3 to the power x, right? Now what do we have instead of k? 3 to the power x. So 3 to the power x should be equal to 9. Again here, instead of k, 3 to the power x, which is equal to 1. Now we can write 9 as 3 square, right? If I write 9 as 3 square, the bases become same. If bases become same, power should be same, which means x is equal to 2. X is equal to 2. Now here you have 1, but I need same base. So I will write this as 3 to the power 0, because anything to the power 0 is 1, right? So now the base is same. So x is equal to 0. So these are the values of x. X is equal to 2 and x is equal to 0. Let's solve this problem. Similar, same approach. We will put 5 to the power y as k. Let's assume 5 to the power y, because there is this one here. So we'll assume 5 to the power y is k. So what I'll substitute? I can write this as like this, minus, I can write this like this, right? 2y, 5 to the power 2y, I can write it as 5 to the power y and 2. Because a to the power m into n is a to the power m into n, right? Now I'll substitute. 5 to the power y is k, and then I have this 2, k square. minus 26k plus 5 is equal to 0. This is nothing but 5k square minus 26k plus 5 equal to 0. Now again, to solve this, I have to use two methods, sum, product or formula. Two methods are there. So here I'll use the formula method. Formula is x is equal to minus b plus or minus root of b square minus 4ac by 2a. This is for the equation ax square plus bx plus c is equal to 0. A, b and c are coefficients of, a is the coefficient of x square, b is the coefficient of x. So basically coefficient means it's the number, any number next to x, that's the coefficient. So now in this equation, I have 5k square minus 26k plus 5. This is a, this is b and this is c. So let's substitute. Instead of x, I have k here. So k is equal to minus b. Instead of b, I have minus 26. Remember the signs, it's minus 26. Plus or minus root of b square, that is minus 26 the whole square, minus 4 into a. A is 5 into c. C is also 5 by 2a. 2 into a. A is 5. So I'll get k is equal to 26 plus or minus 26 the whole square minus 25 is 100. 26 the whole square to 676 by 10. 26 plus or minus, I'll get 576 by 10. Root of 576 is 24. 26 plus or minus 24 by 10. So now I'll have to split this into two ways. 26 plus 24 by 10, because I have plus or minus. So one is with plus, the other is with minus. So this is 26 plus 24 is 50 by 10. And the other one is minus 2 by 10. So this will become 5 and this will become 1 by 5. So you have two values of k, 5 and 1 by 5. So k is 5 and k is 1 by 5. Now what we had assumed, 5 to the y is equal to k. So instead of k, I'll put 5 here. Also, instead of k, I can put 1 by 5 because I have two values of k, right? So now again, bases are same. So power should be same. Here there is no power, which means there is 1. So y is equal to 1. Remember one thing. I can write 1 by 5 as 5 to the power minus 1. Using that keynote. Right? This is nothing but 1 by 5 to the power 1. Now if I take this power on top, it will become 5 to the power minus 1. This means y is equal to minus 1. So y is equal to 1 and y is equal to minus 1. So these are the values of y. So we have solved this equation. Let's go through another problem. 5 to the power 2x plus 1 plus 25 to the power x plus 1 is equal to 150. We'll assume that 5 to the power x is k. Let's do this step by step. It's like this. Plus 25 to the power x plus 1 is equal to 150. So what we will first split this. We can write this as x. Right? 2x. And there's plus 1 here. So now this is, you'll have to use the reverse law. A to the power m plus n is a to the power m into a to the power n. You can split this as 5 to the power 2x and 5 to the power 1. 5 to the power 1. We are splitting this like this. Plus, instead of 25, we'll write 5 square. And x plus 1 is equal to 150. So here also we'll have to split it. Square into 5 plus, I'll split it. I'll write 2x plus 2 is equal to 150. In the next step, now I'll split this portion. I can write it as 2x into 2, correct? I can write this like this. Now again, further I will write this as x and 2 outside. 2x I can write as x2, like this also I can write. 2 into x is same as x into 2, right? So, now I'll substitute. Instead of 5 to the power x, I'll put k and then I have square into 5 plus k square into 5 square is 150. K square is common, right? Right? So I'll take k square outside. I'll have 5 plus 5 square is equal to 150. What is 5 plus 5 square? This is 25 plus 5, 30. So 30k square is 150. 30k square is 150. So what is k square? It will be 150 by 30. on cancelling, it will be 5. So k would be root of 5. I am shifting square here. When I shift square here, it's going to be square root of 5. K is square root of 5. Remember that keynote. If you have like this, a to the power p. When you have something like this, you can write it as a to the p by q. This root will come in the denominator, p by q. Similarly, we can write this k is equal to 5. This is square root, right? This is 2 here. We have brought this 2 here, square root. So it will be 5 to the power 1, you can assume. There's nothing you can assume as 1. 1 by 2. 1 by 2, right? So you have square root of 5, which is nothing but, there's nothing you assume 1. This will be 1 by this 2 comes here, right? That's what you have written. So k is 5 to the power half. What we had assumed? We had assumed 5 to the power x is k. We had assumed 5 to the power x is equal to k. And k is 5 to the power half. So 5 to the power x is 5 to the power half. Bases are same. So power should be same. So x is equal to half. So this is the value of x. Now this is again a similar problem. This is little simpler. What we can do is, we can first use the division law, right? A to the power m by a to the power n is a to the power m minus n. So your bases are same, 7, 7. So we'll shift this, shift the power. So it's going to be like this. You'll have to subtract this power, right? You'll get this. Now, we want to keep the bases same, right? Here you have 7. So we want to make here also, right hand side also 7, right? Why we have to do that? If the bases are same, we can equate the powers. If you equate the powers, then you'll get the value of x. So instead of 49, I can write a 7 square. 7 into 7 is 49. So let's work this out. I'll get 7 3x minus 4 is equal to 7 square 3x minus 14. Now I'll multiply these powers. It'll be 7, 2 into 3, 6x, 2 into 14, 28. Now bases are same. If bases are same, powers have to be same. That means 3x minus 4 is equal to 6x minus 28. Now let's bring x to one side and numbers to the other side. So 3x minus 6x will become 3x minus 6x is equal to minus 28. Minus 4, when it goes to the other side, will become plus 4. So I get minus 24 and this will be minus 3x. Now I'll bring 3 to the other side. So it'll be minus 24 by 3, which is minus 8. So minus x is equal to minus 8. That means x is equal to 8. Minus and minus will get cancelled. So x is equal to 8. So we have found the value of x. With this, we have come to the end of this particular video and chapter. Thanks for watching. Hope this video was useful.